Hey, Rosebank family. Well, we are up and running for the year and excited about our plans for church in the next couple of months, despite not being able to gather together. So as I'm sure most of you know from the news, absolutely no religious gatherings allowed over the next month or so. And so what that means is, well, church online. So Sundays, church online, and then our other opportunities to connect as a community virtually during the week. So Sundays we have church online. We'll be going back to our prayer meeting at the end of January, plus other webinar type events that are coming up in the next month or so to just help keep you connected with the life of the church. Just by the way, a little small way that will really help you, I believe, in your connection with church, especially on a Sunday, is, hey, join our Sunday stream live. So coming to you 9:30 on our Go Live platform, just an opportunity for you to comment and connect with each other, to request prayer. It just does that little bit extra to help us feel connected on a Sunday. So if you haven't tried that yet, give that a try as we navigate this next season, as we kick off the year together. Speaking of Sundays, I'm so excited to tell you about the very first sermon series that we're going to be doing this year. It is called Rule of Life. Rule of Life. And the subtitle is Habits That Help You Form and Fortify Your Faith. So forming and fortifying your faith. So if you're not familiar with what a rule of life is, it's basically a practice that Christians have been practicing for centuries now. And basically it involves incorporating spiritual disciplines into certain habits and rhythms of life. What I love about this idea is that it's entirely contextual. So depending on where you live at what time, there may be different circumstances that require you to fortify and form your faith in different ways. So for example, in our modern urban culture, the time pressure on people, so the stress they're under with work, traffic stress, of course, before COVID, extramural curricular activities for children, etc. There's just a unique time pressure, a busyness pressure that just is not helpful in our spiritual formation. And so in this particular time and context, we would want to build a spiritual rhythm and incorporate some spiritual disciplines to make sure that we can still be adequately spiritually formed amidst this kind of current culture. So that's the idea behind a rule of life. It is a contextualized set of spiritual disciplines and habits that really help fortify our faith amidst particular pressures and stresses, and not just fortify our faith, but form it and shape it. Now, what's exciting about this for us as a church right now is that, as I'm sure you're all aware, man, we are under a very unique set of pressures right now. And so we would love to start the year just kind of taking time to look at six different kind of rhythms or habits that are going to really help us in particular areas of life. So it's going to be a 7-week series, so 7 weeks, and a week of introduction, and then six different rules or habits over the next 6 weeks. And just really looking forward to building into our life, no matter what happens this year. It's all still so uncertain, but no matter what happens, no matter what's coming, we who are serious about our spiritual formation, serious about all the pressures and temptations out there to just consolidate and set ourselves up to thrive this year, not just to survive, but to thrive this year. So we're really excited about that. There's going to be lots of other things added to the series. And so I hope that you'll be joining with us for that journey. And hey, you know what? We're just looking forward to still journeying together as a church this year, despite what's happening. We are learning to trust in God's will of decree, to embrace His will of desire for us, which He's doing in these circumstances, and to lean into His will of direction. And so we're excited to journey with you through the blessed uncertainty of 2021. Love you, church.